And I hope all of you are doing well. I can see few of the students here. Okay. Hi Harshil, hi Aryan, hello Monica. Arey, thank you Monica, thank you so much. I am there right here. Am I visible to all of you? Let me refresh once because I can't see myself. I can't see myself. Am I visible to all of you? Hello Krishna. Hi Siddharth. Okay, yes, I know, I remember. Yes, of course I remember you. Okay. Hi Gopal. Hi Vafa. I'm good. Hello Harshal. Hi Wild Kitty. Okay, now the live chat is not visible. Okay, so Gopal, hi. So let's rock today's session. So as I already told you in the previous session that I'm going to call you as literature lovers. So hi literature lovers, how are you all? Are you all good? Yes or no? Okay, so let's begin today's session, today's amazing session on Dust of Snow. I hope all of you have already viewed the previous video on Dust of Snow and you have understood the poem, not only line by line, but also, yes, the entire meaning, the philosophical message, and yes, the you have already explored underneath the surface level and went into the deeper layers of the poetry. Yes or no, guys? Okay, so did you all go through the previous video, Dust of Snow? Yes or no? So I actually saw your, comments there as well. So I have taken few of the comments which you have, posted in the previous video, and we will really, really discuss that. And you are welcome to post your comments in this session as well. Okay, bacha log? So let's begin with today's session. Well, I cannot see the live chat yet. Anyway, so let's move ahead. So guys, talking about online education, right, which we are providing you. So most of you, I think some of you, I could see that they are already the students of Vedantu and they have come here to visit, right? So those of you who do not, who have yet not subscribed, okay? So this is for those of you, okay? If you are not yet the pro subscriber, then this is for you guys. And this is the right time that you take this initiative, take this step in order to make your learning great with us, right? So we have tried to identify the problems that you have faced in education and you face in education, right? So tell me if you agree with this. So guys, are you there? Because why can't I see the live chat? I don't know why. One second, let me just refresh it. Doubts. Okay, yes, now I can see. Okay, Arjun says I'm a pro student. Okay, so as I told you that many of you are already a pro student. So let us identify the problems. One of you, as you said, doubts. Definitely. Sir, beta, Harry, please look at it carefully. This is ma'am, not sir. Okay, so doubts, notes, tests and assignments, competitive exams, choice of schedule, choice of language. Don't you agree, guys? These are the areas where you face the most of the problems. Yes? So we have tried to identify these problems, and not only that, we have also come up with a solution. So all your doubts are now solved because you are going to get personalized attention in our classes. And with the help of our class teachers as well as the master teacher, all your doubts will be definitely taken care of. And notes, you are going to get handwritten notes of the teachers. Tests and assignments, yes, we are going to prepare you for the tests and assignments with the help of our monthly tests, right? And competitive exams, we have also tried to take care of various competitive exams that you usually face, right? So we are going to absolutely make you exam ready. Schedule, there are various time slots and you can actually choose any of the time slot which suits you, right? Choice of language, which is a major factor. Ma'am, Hindi, we are not comfortable in Hindi. So, of course, we have avenues open up for that. We are not comfortable in English. We want Hindi as a medium of instruction. So, everything is possible, right? Everything is possible in Vedantu, guys. So, yes, we have the choice of schedule also and also choice of language according to your convenience, both Hindi and English. And apart from that, we also have some bonus features. Unlimited live classes, micro course, crash course, performance report, personalized attention. Now, micro course and crash course. Crash course is where you sum up, you revise the entire chapter at a go. And micro course is you give, crash course is complete revision of the syllabus. And micro course is individual attention to each and every chapter. And of course, you have long-term batches as well, right? So these are the various features which are, going to make you absolutely prepared and you will have no problem. So Vedanta becomes, your one-stop solution for all your needs. And it is designed specifically for catering to students' needs, right? So definitely, and we are also providing you the performance report with the help of which you can also analyze which are the areas in which you need more hard work, right? Because it is not only, it's not that you should only work hard. It's important to work smart, and I think Vedantu helps you in working smart, right? So these are the bonus features, and these are the steps that you need to follow in order to subscribe. Choose your grade, choose your board, check out the details, click on get subscription, and you have three types of subscription, guys. One is for 1 month, 3 months, and 6 months. And you can see the difference in the price at the end, before and after the coupon. So yes, I'm going to tell you one coupon code. If you apply that, you're going to get discount, right? So 1 month, 3 months, 6 months. And financially speaking, if you talk about cost effectiveness, then 6 months is, more cost effective. So you can just avail that. But if you're not very certain about that, you can also go for 3 months and 1 month, right? So these are the features, guys, and these are the kinds of subscription that we have. So flexibility here as well, completely in keeping with your convenience and catering to your needs, guys. So what you need to do is just visit vdnt.in/ytpro and use the coupon code SWREPRO. Mind it, there is E, English channel E, okay? So Shweta Roy, E, English channel PRO. Remember the code, guys, and yes, do subscribe. Do not miss this wonderful opportunity, because Vedantu is working only for you guys. Okay? So it's just for you. If you are not there, Vedantu is not there. So guys, I want to see you all. Looking forward to see you all in our sessions very soon. Right, guys. Are Harshil, your birthday? Thank you, Siddharth. Thank you so much. Thank you, Gopal, for telling to hit the like button. Please do hit the like button. Okay, hi, Manthan. Happy birthday, Harshil. Many, many happy returns of the day. Ma'am is Miss India. And who said? Okay. So, ma'am, do you teach in pro subscription? Arre, I'm there. Pro subscription is nothing like, it's just a subscription. You will get all the features. You will get long-term, micro courses. So all the amazing teachers are there. Not only me, but all other teachers are also there, guys. Right? So don't forget, you'll get to see so many teachers. Theek hai bacha? So don't worry about that. Okay? You have wonderful teachers there. So, dust of snow, guys. Ready? Ready to start? Get set, go. Oh, Divya, you have a dust of snow. English exam. Okay, all the best. Okay. Chalo, so let's start off. So we have already done with the complete analysis of the poem in the previous video. I hope you have watched the previous video. And today we are going to discuss the important question, answers, theme, poetic devices, all the important things, okay? Which is really very important for your exam purpose as well. And of course, the next session is going to be your favorite session, Doubt and Mentee. But yes, do not come to the Doubt and Mentee session without, seeing this. So please go through both the videos. And now we are going to start off with an amazing session with a beautiful quote. This is for you guys, literature lovers, as I call you. So please view this quote. Okay, and the quote says, it's by John Milton. The mind is its own place. The mind is its own place. And in itself can make a heaven of hell, a hell of heaven. Do you agree with this quote, guys? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes? Sermon at Banaras. Yes, dear, I will come. Slowly, slowly, I'll come to everything, every chapter. Yes or no, guys? Come on, give me a quick yes. Give me a quick let's rock. Literature lovers, all of you, come on. Okay, so I can see yes. Thank you, Sabina, Harshil, Megamind, Monica, Guruji. Arre, thank you, thank you. Divya also says agreed. So this is a quote by John Milton which stresses on the importance of mind. Everything is there in your mind. If you think that you are living in hell, you will be living in hell. There is no physical place called hell or heaven. It's all in your mind. That is exactly what Milton is saying. And this is exactly relevant to the poem that we are going to read. We have already read that, right? And we are going to analyze the theme and, you know, the symbolic meaning, etc., etc., right? So let's move ahead with today's session. But yes, before that, I'm going to show you two of the comments that your friends have beautifully put it, you know, posted on the for the previous session. One is by Megamind. She says, one day I was feeling very depressed and frustrated for some reason. I went to a nearby field to release my stress. There I saw a dog with a puppy. Wow, that's amazing. That's beautiful. Which instantly transformed my sorrowful feelings into joy. Right. The nature acts as a healer for us, no matter how sad or depressed we all are. Nature makes us happy. So guys, do you agree with your friend Megamind? Yes or no? Hi, Kishore. Hello, Shastri. So she's absolutely correct. Nature heals us with its healing power, with its magical power. It really transports us to the world of magic. Many of us, you know, we all love to go for a vacation to a place which is very close to nature, where we find nature in all its bounty. Yes or no, guys? So as I told you, as I began the previous session with this very fact that, you know, how long has it been when you have not visited a place, not gone for a vacation, Hannah? So that is correct, yes. Okay, so we have Megamind here as well. Great, great, great. So another quote is by student, and I don't know whether it is he or she, anyways. Name is there, Gatha. Okay, Gatha. So she says that, yes, ma'am, I believe in the quote, find a place. Okay, the previous quote that I, came up with. Nature is a remedy to incurable diseases. Absolutely correct. It's a stress buster, healer, and the one who can answer to all our queries. Wonderfully put. Being with nature and mother can both satisfy your mind and refresh it too. I think due to nature's healing powers and beauty, that many people want to spend their time with nature, as I just now told you, right? They try to go to parks and hill station. Definitely, definitely. We all choose either hill station or seaside. Well, I am fond of the seaside. Okay. Hill station as well, right? Because we are all, you know, we feel as if we are embracing nature, right? We feel so rejuvenated. We feel so refreshed, right? Don't you agree with me? So guys, she's asking all of you, don't you agree with her? Yes, we do agree. Literature lovers, come on, make some noise in the chat box. Fan of green, wow, Parmeshwar. Okay. Arjun is asking, did you have your lunch? No, dear, not yet. So thank you guys for all your comments. And apart from this, I also received few other comments, which I read it personally. Thank you so much, everybody, for posting your comments. Keep doing that, literature lovers. Keep rocking. Okay. So literature lovers are also nature lovers. Yes or no? Give me a quick high five. Yes or no? Okay, Siddharth, thank you so much. Hi, Jyoti. I'm starving, Megamind is saying. Okay. Well, I have also not had my lunch yet. So now we will start with the themes of the poem. Okay. Yes, Rachna, please tell me what is the confusion. Thank you for the high five, guys. Thank you so much. Okay, themes of the poem. Please tell me your confusion. Please directly ask the question. Okay. So themes of the poem. Communication between nature and human beings. Definitely the first theme is nature-human communication that we come across in the poem. So the poet is where? He is in the midst of nature, where he has this land filled with snow, and snowfall is occurring, and the tree, which tree? Achha, what was the name of the tree? Guys, what was the name of the tree? Come on, guys. Literature reads about nature a lot. Literature loves nature, yes. Okay, what was the name of the tree. It was a poisonous tree, right? Hanji Kenneth, hemlock tree. Very good. Thank you. So yes, I completely missed. Skipped out of my mind. That was hemlock tree. So when he was standing, you know, under that hemlock tree. So imagine yourself standing under that hemlock tree in a snow-filled area, and you know the dust of snow falling on your body. So definitely direct interaction of nature and human, and that is causing what? That is causing joy and happiness. The earlier dejected mood, depressed mood, was changed into a mood of positivity. As he said that that entire occurrence saved a part of his day from being rude. Rude is, reject, like, what to say, regret. Rude means regret. So he regretted a part of the day. Okay? So that was saved. How? With the help of communication with nature, direct communication with nature, interaction with nature. So first theme that we come across is the communication between nature and human. The next thing that we discussed at length right away from the very beginning of the session is nature's healing powers, nature's magical power, right? Which is, you know, healing the negative emotions. As I also asked you about your incidents where you felt that nature has healed you. So one of you wrote about the puppies, right? Dog and its puppies. So that was a beautiful, a beautiful scene described. So similarly, there are so many other scenes, other examples, instances wherein you will find that nature is healing you. It is taking you out of your feeling of dejection, depression. Whenever you feel depressed, dejected, try to go to your terrace or any open space. As I told you, try to walk. You know, when you wake up in the morning, try to find out a green place, green grass, and try to, walk there. You will find peace. You will find comfort. You will find the healing power of nature. You will find direct communion with nature, right? And yes, it is good for your eyesight as well, right? So, next is the significance of small incidents. Now, what is the significance of small incidents, natural events? Now, this crow, this is a very simple occurrence. The crow shaking off the branch of the tree and the dust of snow falling on the body. That is very, it's an incident which is almost negligible. But this had a great significance in the poet's life. So many a times, this also happens in our life. Very small occurrence which, otherwise could be ignored, like a baby smiling, a flower blooming. Very small incident play a very important role in our mind, in our mood. It acts as a mood changer for us, right? Just as your friend described the scene about the puppy, right? So similarly, this scene of the crow sitting on the branch of tree shaking down the dust of snow was a very simple and a small event, not a very not an event to be commemorated or something like that, but yes, it did have a very positive and a deep impact on the poet's mood because it saved a part of his day from being, going into a waste. Or he regretted, whatever he regretted initially, that was completely changed. Yes. Okay, Megamind, that I get. I agree with you. Okay, ma'am, when the powdery snowfall on the poet fell from the tree, wasn't it poisonous? No, dear. The hemlock tree is poisonous no matter, but the thing is that the snow is falling. So how would the snow, take the poison? Until and unless you are not consuming that tree, that is nothing of the, there is nothing poisonous about it, right? It's just the snow falling from it. Okay, so. Now. Use of nature in dust of snow. Okay, one of you are asking about the irony, definitely. I'll tell you about that as well. Sanju says, the subtleties of life is what makes life so beautiful and perplexing. It is a beautiful journey and it is the small joys that play a significant role in our life which brings smile to our face. Definitely, Sanju. Very well said. Okay, so use of nature is important question for your paper as well. How does Wordsworth use nature here? Now, first of all, I already talked about the positive symbols of nature and the negative symbols, right? Hemlock tree, he starts the very poem with the hemlock tree and the crow. both used as negative symbols. Pro is generally seen as something bringing bad luck or ill omen, right? But here, this and hemlock tree is poisonous. But these two symbols, which are the so-called negative symbols or negative images, is transformed into something positive. And that is exactly the irony, guys, right? Also, you could say that is the irony, because we expect these, symbols like hemlock tree and crow, these symbols are usually taken as ominous symbols. So we expect something dangerous happening, or something happening which is something negative happening. We have this expectation because both are negative symbols. However, at the end of the at the end of the poem, this expectation, there is a gap between what we expect and what we actually get. Definitely, we expect negativity because the poem starts with a gloomy atmosphere, negative symbols, but at the end, this negativity is transformed into positivity, and that can also be seen as an irony because there is a gap between expectation and reality, right? So Dust of Snow expresses a man's passion for nature. Definitely all about nature. Nature symbols are used. Nature acts as a healing power when a man finds himself in distress, and that is exactly how the Dust of Snow healed him with its magical power. But what caused that dust of snow to fall on his body? It is the action of the crow sitting on the hemlock tree. Both the symbols are negative, however, transformed into something positive, which reminds us of the quote which we read right now about nothing is positive or negative, it is just our mindset, right? So guys, let's be optimistic every time. Let's look at the things with a positive light, right? Nature is a pleasant thing and an appreciating ground during mental stress. This we all did right away. The poet personifies a tree into a man's best friend. Definitely, although it was a hemlock tree, it was a poisonous tree. However, it was, it was filled with snow, and it is that snow which fell on his body, changed his mood. And definitely, when we mean nature, we also mean tree, obviously comes in, in that. And then, crow, it's an awful bird. It's not a beautiful bird like the people, the other poets use beautiful birds like nightingale, cuckoo, or the other nightingale, cuckoo, and other beautiful or singing birds, right? Skylark for that matter, right? But here, the poet has used unconventionally the symbols of nature. He has used in an unconventional manner, right? Not traditionally, but yes, unconventionally. And here he has used crow, right, which is otherwise regarded as a bird, which is negative. And we hardly have read any poem about crow, which has a crow in it, right? However, it is still a part of the nature, right? So snow dusting from the tree frustrated the poets, but overpowers a simple nature. That means it could have led to frustration. The snow which is falling on the body, some of you might be frustrated. Oh my God, it's raining. There are two kinds of people. One who loves rain, one who loves snow. The other feels, oh, again, rainfall is coming. Let's go, let's run. Oh my God, I'm getting wet, right? So this could also have been the case with the poet, where he could have, been frustrated with the snow. But that at that point, the snow dust falling on his body gave him a sense of pleasure. Right? It overjoyed him. So that is the beauty of nature, and that is all about the healing power of nature. Okay, why is Robert Frost a poet and not an author? This is a poem, guys. This is a poem. So here we will call him as a poet. Okay? Yeah, exactly. Exactly, Sabina, because he wrote poems. Very simple. Chayan Das, Darun Laglo Apnar Porano. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Okay. William Wordsworth is one of the most famous romantic poets, who is always fascinated by the endowments of nature and always appreciate the subtleties of life. Yes, definitely. Daffodils also exemplifies this. Absolutely. Tejas is saying, can you tell me if we can start from any chapter that we want in pro subscription, or everything will be done, Tejas? You have the micro courses for that, right? सो डोंट वरी, ईच एंड एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग टू बी कवर्ड, ठीक है? अरे थैंक यू रूपना, थैंक यू सो मच. ओके सॉरी. नाउ द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ द टाइटल. सो एज यू कैन सी द टाइटल इज डस्ट ऑफ स्नो. सो द एंटायर पोएम रिवॉल्व्स अराउंड व्हाट? द एंटायर पोएम रिवॉल्व्स अराउंड डस्ट ऑफ स्नो. व्हाट इज डस्ट? द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ स्नो. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस पार्टिकल ऑफ स्नो डूइंग? इट इज फॉलिंग फ्रॉम द ब्रांच ऑफ द हेमलॉक ट्री. Who is making that fall? The activity of the crow, right? And when it is falling on the poet's body, it is changing his mood from positive, from negativity, from depression to something which is positive, right? So he is overjoyed, right? So that is the change of mood that he is, talking about. So when you are talking about the significance of the title, you have to talk about the theme that we right now did. You have to talk about the nature symbols and what is the message that is conveyed here. First of all, simplest thing in our life can, be very significant, right? And the second is nature as a healer. And the third is nothing is negative or positive, but whatever we view as negative can sometimes be also transformed into positive. It is all in our mind. You can also include Milton's quote, right? So these are the few points that you need to mention when you talk about the title, right? Relevance of the title. And now let's move ahead with the poetic devices. So I hope you can see the poetic devices. So first is the rhyme scheme, which is A B A B C D C D. Check it. That is the rhyme scheme of the poem. And then the poetic devices says, okay. So Divya says the small things which had a negative significance in life brought about a positivity in Frost. Absolutely. This is the irony. Exactly. This is the irony. Thank you. Thank you, Divya. I can't, because I am not visible right now, I am showing you the literary devices and then I will be visible very soon, don't worry. So, talking about the poetic devices, the first is the way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree. So, you can see, shook down on me. So, there is the repetition of O sound here. O, 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 right? So, this is assonance, okay? What is assonance? Repetition of the vowel sound. So, O, 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 repeated. Now, alliteration, it's the repetition of the consonant sound in the first syllable. That is, has given my heart. So, H, H, that is alliteration. And then again, saved some. So, S, S, that is repetition of the alliteration. Right? And here, another figure of speech which is not mentioned here is, day I had root. This would be consonants. Right? Because this is the repetition of consonant sound, but not necessarily in the beginning of the, in the first syllable. It's there in the middle. See, day is here, then had, D is again at the end, and D is again at the end. So here you can see that it is not necessarily in the beginning. Right? So this will be consonants. I forgot to mention it over here, but I'm telling you right away. Take care. This is consonants. Please do not get confused about alliteration and consonants. Alliteration happens at the beginning of the syllable. For example, here, has heart, saved some. And here you have day, the. D sound is repeated, but not necessarily at the beginning. Right? And consonants is just the opposite of assonance. So I hope now you are clear with it. So let me come back again. Take care. And now let me come back with the first question. Right, guys? Hanji, I just asked you something which I don't know. Yes, Shiv Kumar, please tell me. No, Shubham, I'm not ignoring you. Okay. So, poets have great power of imagination. Robert Frost also explains his imagination very well and proves that sometimes bad symbols change into a boon. Very important question, guys. And that is what your friend Divya talked about. That is the irony, right? Bad symbols changed into what? Changed into something positive, right? So let us discuss this. So he represents the crow and the hemlock tree as inauspicious. In the very beginning, crow and hemlock tree both are used as negative symbols to represent something which is inauspicious, bringing ill luck, bringing ill omen, right? In a hemlock is a poisonous tree and crow is what? Crow is something which is regarded as inauspicious. So if a crow sits in front of your window, and you hear its voice, you feel you shoo it away directly, right? Because you don't like its coarse voice and you think that that is something which is going to be very inauspicious. However, this is all in our mind. That is what exactly Milton says when he says that mind is a place. So this is all in our mind. Nothing is positive and nothing is negative. Even the negative which you think as negative can sometimes be transformed into something positive, and these negatives actually gives you something positive, just as it happened in this poem. When the crow shook off the dust of snow, it fell on the poet and it made the it changed his dejected mood and saved his day from being spoiled, right? So that is how the negative images, the inauspicious images in the first stanza is in the next stanza transformed into something beautiful, something bringing positivity and changing his mood from negativity to positivity. Right, guys? Moving ahead with the next question. Our attitude towards a situation evokes both negative and positive response. Analyze this with reference to the poem Dust of Snow to bring out the inherent valuable lesson. So this is something which we all should relate with our lives. What say guys? Yes or no? Absolutely, Parmeshwar. There is no such thing as positive and negative. Our mind is the one that decides what is. Okay, there are two types of people, as Sanju says, optimistic and pessimist. Absolutely, optimistic people try to educate positivity in every situation, and pessimistic people are contrary to that. Optimism is the key. Absolutely, absolutely. Thank you. What is this halwa question? Huh? Okay, so if it is so easy, then please tell me the answer. Aryan, I want to see the answer from your end. Okay, so whatever the situation life throws at us, it evokes both positive and negative response. So how can you actually inculcate this in your life? Now, in your life, you would also be surrounded with lots and lots of negativity, lots and lots of negative situations. But you have to be very optimistic, because you all know that everything is in our mind. Right? So if you take a positive approach in your life, if you have a positive outlook, you can also transform the negative into positive, just as the crow, the hemlock tree, which are so-called negative, inauspicious things, they all brought in something positive. Similarly, in your life also, you will be faced with negative situation, but it is your own mindset which can transform that negativity into positivity. Right, guys? So always you need to be positive. Now, be positive is not a blood group here. It is the thought process. Okay? It is the optimistic value that we all should inculcate in our life. Okay? Okay. Good afternoon, Shubh. Good afternoon. Hanji Sanki, Menti is in the next session. Okay? So the poet, as you know in the poem, was in a sorrowful mood. However, when the crow shook down the dust of snow on him, his bitter mood changed into a more optimistic one. Now here, if he had thought about the crow as an inauspicious symbol, right, then he would have been angry. He would again, if you be angry at that inauspicious symbol, then you would again be filled with negative emotion. So that is why I am saying you also have to have an optimistic outlook in your life. Just as the poet did not consider the crow as something negative, as a negative symbol, and the hemlock tree as something negative, that is why he was overjoyed by seeing the crow shaking down the dust of snow on his body. Right? So that is why it is important to have always a positive outlook. It helps you in better decision making. It makes you strong in life. Right, guys? So guys, come on, give me an optimistic yes. So always say yes. Always be positive, right? Okay. Chalo. Okay, there is a movie called Khayali Pulao, which highlights the little joys of life and how sometimes it's things in life that makes beautiful. Okay, I have not seen that movie. So if you are saying that, I must research on that. Khayali Pulao. Okay, thank you for that. Exactly. Wow, Divya has beautifully put it. It's more like shaking down the snow on your worries. Wow. That's great. That's great. That's great. Okay. Now, being in a sorrowful or bad mood already, the poet could have got angry at the crow, as I told you. But what did he do? The dust of snow, however, becomes a positive medium of change for him. He did not get annoyed at the snow, nor the dust of snow being, which fell on his body by the activity of the crow. However, it acted as a positive medium of change in him because he never considered anything as, inauspicious. Right, guys? It made him cheerful to some extent and helped him forget his sadness at least for a few moments, right? So as I told you that you should always embrace positivity in your life and definitely you will forget about all your worries. And if you go to closer to nature, look at the symbols of nature, right? Look at the elements of nature, you try to interact with nature and, that will lead to great positivity in your life as well, just as it led in the poet's mind. And then we see that instead of seeing the negative aspect of a happening, we should see the positive one, right? And one's response may greatly affect the outcome of incidents. So many incidents will have negative outcome, but your response, if it is positive, then you can also change the negative into positive, just as we saw in this poem. Next question, guys. Next question. Angie, Insta broken page, shout out for you, shout out for all of you. Tell more about the subscription. Yes, I will tell you about the subscription again, don't worry. Ye kya yaar, gajar ka halwa and all this. Okay, yes, Divya, I will definitely watch that Khyali Pulao, definitely. Okay. So our mental condition depends on our surroundings and it can be changed according to it. Explain and prove. So this is exactly what was said in the quote at the beginning of the session, right? Our mental condition depends on surroundings and it can be changed according to it. It's about our mind, right? So if we go to greener places, when we go to a green place and try to imagine that you have been transported into a green place filled with greenery everywhere, and you have waterfall, how overjoyed you feel, how soothing is the effect, how serene you feel, right? So that is the healing power of nature. We get immense pleasure out of it in the lap of nature, right? And then this poem also describes it. The poet was sitting under a hemlock tree. He was actually standing under a hemlock tree in a dejected mood. But when the poet, when the crow, shook this tree and the dust of snow fell on the poet, it changed the poet's mood. Okay? And this was a pleasant incident. Next question, guys. Next question. Next question is, the poet has succeeded in giving valuable information in a light-hearted manner. Very, very important, guys. Light-hearted, in a light-hearted manner, he has given a very valuable information. What creates the desired effect and highlight its importance in the present day life? What do you think about it? What do you think about it, guys? What do you think about it? Okay, so he says, Parmeshwar says, I am a fan of nature and I've transformed my home into a jungle. Okay, so let's move ahead with the answer. We should not take nature for granted, absolutely. We should accept it in whichever way the nature chooses us to bless us. Very good, Sarika, absolutely. Yes, of course, there are always two sides of a coin. Let this pandemic crisis be an opportunity to do something great and be a better version of ourselves. Definitely, definitely. So Frost has used simple language. You have already read the poem and you have seen how simply he has written this poem in a very simple language, very clear for our understanding. There is no use of difficult words even. But the apparent simplicity, don't be, you know, misled by the apparent simplicity, right? So Frost has used simple language to drive home a very significant message. Apart from this, simple poem, but it has a very deep message for all of us, right? What is that message? That little things have a big impact in our life. So some of you, say this, right? That I find joy in little pleasures of our life, small pleasures of my life, right? So many of you, even I, find happiness in little things. And that sometimes these little things, which we call as little, they have a large impact and a great impact in our lives. Don't you agree, guys? Don't you agree? Okay, Bhumika says, positivity and negativity are opposite sides of the same coin. It totally depends on our mind. Exactly. That is okay. An easy, uncomplicated language coupled with unusual visual imagery and brevity of words create the desired effect of the poem, guys. Right or no? The poet's bitterness finds reflection even in the environment around him in the very first stanza when he talks about the hemlock tree and the crow, right? So it was his bitterness which found reflection in the environment. The noisy dark crow, the poisonous hemlock. These were the depressing images, and there was a creation of the gloomy atmosphere in the beginning. However, this gloomy atmosphere changed into something positive at the end, in the next stanza. So despite the negativity, when the crow shakes down the dust of snow, it shakes off some of the poet's regretful thoughts. Today, when all of us live in stressful atmosphere, the poem teaches us to gain happiness from little things. So today, even if you talk about today in this pandemic, state, right? So we are all living together in a stressful situation, stressful atmosphere, but we are all together in this, right? So we can gain happiness from the little things, right? Okay. So now this is the question for you to work on. This is the homework that I want to see you working on in the comment section as well. So post the answers in the comment section, don't worry. What is the theme of the poem? I talked about the theme, right? I talked about the theme when I said that little things, create a great impact in our lives. Then there is nothing as positive or negative. Right, it is just our mindset and how nature is acting as a healing power, right? So the power of nature to heal us, to rejuvenate us, to save us from all our worries, anxieties. So these are the basic themes of the poem, and I started with the theme communion with nature. I started with the theme, guys. If you have not watched, please watch it again. Okay. Chalo, fine. So guys, one of you told me to talk a little bit more about the subscription. So guys, what you need to do is, the link that I have already mentioned, I will mention it once again. If you click on that link, you will get these options. Choose your grade, choose your board, check out the details. All the details are here, right here. Okay? You will get what are the features that you are going to get. You will get the study material, you will get the master classes, you will get all these micro courses, crash course. These are the special courses that you can also avail only if you subscribe, right? Only with this one subscription you can avail all these these innumerable features. Your doubts are going to be absolutely clarified with the help of the master teacher as well as the class teacher. You're going to get personalized attention in each and every class, right? And you're also going to we conduct monthly tests as well, right? So monthly tests may you will in the monthly test you are also getting the performance report. So on the basis of these performance report, you can analyze what is your weak point, where you need to work a little bit more, right? So that is enabling you to work smart, not just work hard but also work smart, right? And you will get time slots, so definitely you can choose your own time schedule. And you are also getting what else? Yes, and yes, language. So choice of language also you can get. Everything is written here. What is included in Vedantu Pro, you will get all the features here. So just click on the link and check out the details. You will see that all the details are written. I have also told you all the details. Apart from this, you can also see what are the details over here, right? So it will be wise enough if you go to this link and check out. And there are three types of subscription: 1 month, 3 month subscription, which I already mentioned, right? So just go to this link and check out. ठीक है, SWREPRO is the code. ठीक है, SWREPRO. So thank you so much guys for watching and thank you for staying tuned. Poetic devices I have mentioned here. I have mentioned. Okay. Thank you so much. Monica, please check out the video once again. I have already mentioned the poetic devices. ठीक है? So thank you guys. Bye bye. Take care. See you again in the next session. Do not forget to like the video. And if you have not subscribed to this new channel, we want your support, guys. We need your support. This is just for you, your benefit, that we have come up with a new channel called English Channel because you were facing difficulty in the previous channel in understanding Hindi, right? So please do appreciate our hard work by liking and subscribing and also sharing. And do not forget to comment in the comment section, right? Post your comments on the homework question, right? So thank you so much, guys. Take care. Bye-bye. See you again in the next session.